Hello everyone, today I'm going to participate in Codeforces round 934. Let's see how it goes. Max game number one, and we have max game number two. Okay. So we, if we play for Alice, want to maximize our max, which means, okay. If there is no zero, then the game is over immediately. If there is a zero, if there is exactly one zero, then we have to take it. Okay. If there is strictly more than one zero, then we may want to secure something else. We can hold the zero. Oh, yeah. Oh yeah. So the answer is the first number that is only one of it plus one. Okay. Okay, I trust you. The sample test. Okay, we have to participate, submit our solutions under this language. If you watch from the far future, because there was a bug recently, it caused some weird time limit exceeded verdicts. Okay, where is the flow in this logic? Let's go goes first, right? Okay. Okay, if we have at least two of them, at least two of them, at least two of them. And then if we have only one this number. Can Alice? Ah, yeah. Of course. Yes, I am wrong. If we only have. Oops. Like this, right? Why is it so long? Is the compilation so long? I know why, because I updated my C++ recently. Okay. Okay. Doesn't matter. Now it should be right, because now I can counter it for Bob. And overall prove my solution. So careless, okay. Okay, good. There is at least one substring that is not a palindrome. Okay, if k is even, then the string is not good. Almost only if all of them are equal. Okay. Okay, so first of all, if k okay, let's think. Consider all substrings of length k. If they are all palindromes, then we have some relation established, like this equals this, and so on. For example, if k equals 2, then the string is bad if and only if all of them are equal. If k equals 3, then if n is 3, then okay. N is 4, then this are equal and this are equal. If n is at least 5, then no. If k is odd, then we always have this relation that all these are equal. If k is 3, I mean, all these are equal. If k is 4 and n is 4, then of course this and this. If n is at least 5, then this and this and this and this. Yeah, so. If k is even and n is at least k plus 1, then n must be all equals, right? Am I right or am I wrong? Or yeah, this must equal this. Yeah, let's begin with the middle ones. These are these, and then this. Okay. And similarly, if k is odd, then okay. Yeah, this seems good. So. We want to check if the string is itself a palindrome, which we can do, for example, using moniker. Moniker 2n minus 1. That makes sense. Okay, now we want to check okay, this is easy. Print next part if and plus not just n and n n minus 1 and n minus 2 is yeah, okay. Next part if e equals if this, then this otherwise just this. I have to, probably have to surround this by parentheses. Oh wow! R is strictly greater than L. Why? What is the point of this? Okay, I mean, now I think. Where is the center of this? L plus R minus 1, right? Yeah. And moniker actually returns what? Let me think. The length of the string, okay. The length of the string, okay. Sum of okay. If moniker of this is strictly less than this, times plus equals this. Then, for all smaller ones, if next part diff of L is at least R, and thanks for your constraint, next part diff of L plus 1 is at least R. Sorry. Then we have to add all odd numbers from 3 to most of this. If okay, if the same then we add sum of all even numbers. Okay, long sum odd 3 till the average is half of this, and the total count is this, half of this. Okay. Actually, the same goes here. No, because I decided to I think it's okay if I do this if I output them using spaces. Okay, now I have to invest into Okay. Shell cmd. What the heck? It used to work. Am I crazy? Okay. Yes. Isn't it the same? Okay, very weird. Okay, ooh, C and D1 are also 1,250 points. Ooh. Yeah, of course. First of all, yeah, okay. The answer is at least the diameter over 2, and we always can do this by taking the center of the diameter. What do we want to output? Okay, just V and D. Okay, that's too stupid, sorry. 2000? What the fuck? What the fuck? Okay. What? Okay. 1, 2, 3. Let's check just to humor ourselves. 7, 2, 7, 5, 7, 6, 6, 1, 6, 4, 2, 3. Yes, this works. Here I have to choose one. Okay, here I don't matter what I choose. 1, 0. Yeah, and here 1, 1, and 2, 1. But I chose. Wait, why? Ah, so if 1, then I have to output 2. And if it was 0, then. Okay, so what did I miss? Okay, but for any vertex, if we fix a diameter, any vertex, paints at most 2 vertices from the diameter, any operation. Then and these two are necessarily of the same color, so if the diameter is if it is of length, for example, 8, then we can do it in 4 operations. 4 operations, 4 operations. Oof. Yeah. Okay. Okay, let me think. And over 2 plus 1 over 2 plus 1 plus 1 over 2 plus 1 over 2. Or int. Yeah, no. No? Or yes? Or no? What do we want? Okay, so we go from P to, oh wait, no, from not P this number of times. Okay. I think this should work for, and this works indeed. This also works. Okay, let's go. Oh, Z1 is small, but Z2 is kind of expensive, as expensive as E1. Still don't know why n is up to 2000. This is really weird. Did they intend to use some dynamic programming stuff, or I don't know. Okay, constraint on n here is 400, here is 3000, so kind of cube or square, but we'll see. All the elements we can. Strictly less highlighted in red. Okay. Okay. So it is kind of the usual operation, but we can only do it on subsegments of then at least 2. And can't we do this? We can't do it. If and don't leave, we have a strict local maximum. At least one strict local maximum. Okay? So we just don't want any strict local maximum. Maxima. P is a prime, right? Yes. Poof. By the way, I need to probably change, modify my script a little bit so that I will have my library. They seem linked to my library also here. Meanwhile, we are half an hour into the contest. Didn't really feel like half an hour, but. Okay, this should be easy. K is at most n, by the way. This is also the case here. Hmm. Why isn't it a stupid DP? Nope. The sum of n squared most a lot. Okay. How is it? Okay. Really, n cubed and n squared? Or... Okay, DP 1 and 0 equals 1. Okay. T equals this equals this. Okay, then this is if we didn't, if it is greater than the previous one. And otherwise, if we, this if it's not greater than the previous one, so okay. I believe this is it. And now we want the good ones, or the bad one, which is zero. ZP and this. The bad one, which is zero. Next type. Okay. Actually, okay. Obviously, I made a mistake. 3, 1. Oh, no. Wait, please. GP, C, 0, right? Sorry, GP, T, I. Okay. 4, 7, 9. 3 and 2. Okay, this is okay, if the first is not 0. So 1, but then the next one is at least 1. But the answer is 9. Where is the 10th? What am I missing? I'm missing this. Fuck. They are right, of course. Okay, next interpretation. Let's try this. One. Okay, let's consider the adjacent differences. Then we can do -1, +1, but only if they differ at least by 2. But if we will do something like greedily assign leftmost to leftmost and so on, then we will be fine. Obviously, this is how we must do it. Okay, so we want this to work. And we can only for example, consider the operations of decreasing 1 on a subsegment of length 2 and on a subsegment of length 3. Yeah, and yeah, we want to be able to do this and using this. It is still not unique, right? It is not unique, how exactly? What can be the algorithm of doing this? How can we find out that we'll fail? Or rather, maybe we can somehow understand when no. Okay, assume that we can only use subsegments of land 2, then it is easy, all these alternating sums that switch, like don't switch the sign at one point, should be non-negative. Okay, okay, assume I know how to find this. I'm not, I don't, but let's forget about this for now. And what if we also want to use people sometimes. I mean, I guess we can use some complex stuff similar to this, but do we want it though? I don't want it for one. I want something easier. Okay, let's try to apply simple rules. For example, if we used a triple, then we won't use a double right after it. Also, if we used a triple, then we won't use a triple right after, like one step further. And also we want to use a triple three steps further, so we'll use nothing three steps further, not a triple one step further. Okay, sounds good. I think this should define a unique way to resolve it. Then we can use some DP, I think. Or rather, so that we used some doubles and triples. Let's see. Let's say that instead of triples, we use doubles. And here we have some remaining numbers, remaining stacks. Okay. What are the rules in this case? I think the rules are simple. If we have two non-zero stacks. We had something like here and here and here double, then this is a contradiction. Is that it? If you have two stacks on different parities, and we used at least one double between them, like with the step 2, then we don't want this, otherwise we don't care. Okay, this sounds like a plan. So the DP will be something like... No, this is 4th power. And this is a mess. Okay, we don't want single stacks. Okay, let's try to calculate the bad ones instead. A bad configuration has a long stack, local maximum. Which we would like to okay, let's think in another setting. As we already know, kind of, this is a linear algebra. So we don't want would be nice to have some invariant, but we will probably not. Okay, what about problem E? M is up to 15, it's interesting. Here M is up to a lot. Okay, Z is should be my type of problem. Why can't I solve it? I'm not sure. Okay, again, consider adjacent differences. If we have some okay, when are we in a bad place? When is it a bad configuration? Simple, when there is something like okay, when will we have kth segment removed? Where is it located? From the kth 1 to the kth minus 1, right? If they are at least one position apart, then we are screwed. Okay. We would like to do something like dp of I don't know something. If the left border is now here, and the right border is now here. We can go from the left border to whatever position we want if it wasn't occupied by the right border. Except the immediate one before it. Or we can go from the right border to anywhere else. So we can define the state by the following. Where the left border is, where the right border is. Fuck no, we cannot. We want to ensure that the numbers are sufficiently small. Okay, let's return back to the setting. How? Okay, if we moved up k times in total and moved down k times in total, then it is a separate component, isn't it? Yeah, so it is basically... Ah, no, it's not. Think okay, but at any point of the border, the number of upwards steps minus the number of downward steps is our current level, right? So if the number of downward steps was k, number of upward steps at this point was k plus our level. How does it matter? Sorry. So we are currently here. And we know that the number of our current level, let's call it h, if we go here, it will be at least this. Okay, that's it. So basically no one can be larger strictly larger. Yes, strictly larger, I think, than its two neighbors. Okay. Well, that was easy. Is at least on Q. It's easy, it should be easy. So it's P of position and current last minus previous. No, wait. Not that easy. I know, maybe it is easy. Wait a minute. Okay, bad. No, not bad. Let's say root of n equals all of n minus sum from 1 to n of sum, I don't know, a, b, root of I minus 1 k times all n minus I b times k minus I a minus b plus 1, something like this. No, just k minus a minus b. Okay. Okay. N, all of n is just k plus 1 to the nth power. All of n minus I and b is kind of k plus 1 to the n minus I power, or something if it is the last, I don't care. Yeah, good of n a is also clear how to calculate. Let's do it. More carefully. Root of n and l equals k plus 1 to the n minus 1, which means all possible options that end with l minus the bad options, which are sum from 1 to n minus 1 something root of, we do it more carefully. Okay. Sum of I from 1 to n minus 1. Sum of k from 0 to k. Root of I minus 1 k. Then no, Oh god, no, no, no. Okay, no, I want to use some trick. If two consecutive elements are equal, then we don't really care. If this is greater, then we only care about the difference. Oof. Not only the difference, okay. Yeah, kind of, almost, at least the difference. The next element must be at least the difference. But if it will be smaller, fuck, wait, I want to think. Assume that we care about the previous element and the difference, okay? This is just the cubic solution. Let n be 4, 4, 4, for example. Okay, the previous element and the lower bound on this element. Okay. Okay. So to not break the previous guy. Yeah, this will be an X, and then maximum of 0 into an X minus last, okay? Something like this. Okay, this is the easy version. Oh. This took me 43 minutes. Hopefully it is correct at least. Would be like 10 to the 8th power operations. I hope my modular arithmetic class is efficient enough. Okay, it is. Now, yeah, let me copy it here. How can we optimize it? I think the secret lies in this formula. I really think so. But so much don't want to expand it and stuff. Okay. Assume that we have this. This number is the first one that violates our constraint. Therefore, this should be a good sequence. By good, what do I mean by good? By good sequence, I mean that I don't know. I don't know. Time close. Right, I mean. If this is A, and this is B, then after this, we have something like, this should be strictly less than B minus A. And then we can have whatever. This will somehow collapse, okay? So if we have here A, of course this is not the violating stack. Okay, I have a trick, I think. Let's say good of NA is how many sequences are good of length n and ends with AA. Okay. Root of n a let's say n without the a so then a and this is all good. Then good n a. Our answer is good of n 0. The good of n a equals, first of all, k plus 1 to the nth power minus, let's see, if the sequence is not good, then there is a stack that is bad. It can be the first one. First one, we will replace it with the formula later, or it can be at least the second one. So it will be minus sum of I from 1. To n minus 1 wait, can I and I guess yeah, okay. Sum of, let's call it C, sum of A from 0 to K, sum of B from A plus 1 to K, good of I minus 1 A okay, these are all good. These are good, this is forcefully good. And then B minus A minus 1 times something. Okay. Let's draw this diagram somewhere here in the corner. A, B. Less than B minus A. Here, whatever. Yeah, this will be good. Okay. So, good of NC equals k plus 1 to the nth power. Minus if it is the first one that violates the constraint. Well, assume that n is greater than 0. Then we have Okay, no, I want this. Good 0a plus 1, obviously. Good 1a equals a plus 1. Finally. Okay. Good and C equal.
Thank you for watching. Bye. Hope. Microphone is closing. Bye bye.